Balcombe in West Sussex. We're here for a guest speaker who's come over from France. He's going to talk about his involvement in the fracking over there and his resistance to it. So let's go and have a listen to what he's got to say. Yeah, can you hear me, mate?
Also, this is a sign. We have to continue those meetings. We have to get organized on a European level with all those anti-fracking protests in Europe to make a difference in this battle against unconventional gas and oil fracking. This is very good, because if you challenge an industry like we did with the nuclear industry in Germany, you must be strong. Yeah. Obviously, it's given already.
That's all right, Kenny, you're not on.
Second, you have fun. This is also visible. And without fun, I can tell you, in Gorleben, we would not have survived our movement for 35 years now. And then you must be smart. I saw this morning some nice videos on very creative, non-violent actions to show why you are fighting against shale gas. I was shown by Paddy some videos of people who blocked Total gas stations. And this is so exactly what you have to do if you want to focus on the problems. Yeah? So with non-violent direct action to show what you are concerned about and how strong your concerns are, so that you are even ready to do such actions. Second, yes, information matters. So you can't talk enough about the problems you are seeing. Talk. This was a Gorleben and anti-nuclear experience over the decades. And always, if you think we have said it already twice, say it for a third time, why you oppose fracking. Third point, I came from the movements to the parliament. When in Gorleben in the year 1977, the nuclear industry, helped by the government of Germany, decided to go for the dumping of all the nuclear waste in my home region, I, with especially farmers from my home region, we organized a citizens' movement. It looked pretty much like what I see around here. Yeah? We were not really political people. We wanted a sustainable development for our region. We wanted to be farmers, gardeners, etc., and we did not want the nuclear industry. And we later on discovered that it's not enough with the direct action. We organized more and more protests also in the capitals of our country. We went to Hanover, we went to Bonn, later on to Berlin. I think there is no way around to bring your protest to where the decisions are made. And what also was very, very important, we decided as a movement that, yes, we can grow, we can be strong, but we need also people who pick up our interests in the decision-making and in the law-making. And this is exactly what, since 10 years, in Europe, I'm trying to do 10 years before I did it in the European Parliament. I think so movements need a kind of arm in the parliaments. Otherwise, you can grow, but the decisions will be made without you. This is maybe not the most beloved point in the discussions of movements, but think about it. And the last point I want to make, we had the experience in the anti-nuclear movement. We had a strong, strong challenge with the nuclear projects foreseen in my home region and in many other regions of Germany. From the very beginning, we had this nuclear industry as the no chapter in our program as a movement. But from the very beginning, we had also the yes chapter in our program. For example, we never only said nuclear, no thanks. We said always, Gorleben soll leben. So Gorleben shall be alive. Gorleben needs a future. And to this slogan, we also developed a positive energy strategy. So in the very beginning, you might remember the very, very small wind turbines and strange things, how to warm water with the help of the sun. Today, if you look on what we have as a renewable technology, as efficiency technology, this all started in my country based on the ideas of the anti-nuclear movement. So there are those sunny alternatives, and I can't believe that in the United Kingdom people can stick to the old energy model based on nuclear and fossils, because this is exactly what's happening. Hinkley Point C stays for the nuclear option, and fracking is the prolongation of the fossil age. So take care. If I can help you later on, if I can help you by cooperation, if I can bring you some smart ideas from direct action groups in my home region, I will always be ready to come back. And especially also to visit the positive side of this region. I'm a gardener by profession. I have seen already this morning, I have to come back because of the gardens. We'll be right back.